Sometimes we plan our photo shoots with our friends so that they can help you click amazing pictures for you guys. But in the end, they have some other work, so that's the reason why they couldn't make it to your photo shoots. In the end, you are left out all alone, and that's the reason why you might cancel the plan. It's so frustrating. I know I have been in a situation where I used to depend on my friends to click my pictures. But what if I tell you that you can click your pictures by yourself without anyone's help? Let's dive into this video right after this intro. What's up everyone, my name is Jasper Desh and I help you guys with fashion, lifestyle and photography through my YouTube channel. And today in this video, I'm going to teach you how to click your pictures without anyone's help. You just have to invest some amount of money in some gears that I will be showing you in this video, but I'm sure that they are not too expensive, alright? And you know what, you can find some alternatives to those equipments that I'm going to show in this video at your home itself. So let's dive into this video real quick. First of all, you need a light stand and a phone mount so that you can clamp your phone on the light stand. Why I'm suggesting a light stand instead of a phone tripod is because there are two reasons for it. The first reason is you can extend your light stand up to 9 feet tall, which is a big bonus point so that you can click some aerial pictures. But whereas if you compare a typical smartphone's tripod, then that's way smaller than a light stand. Let me tell you one thing, that this video is specifically for those guys who don't have a DSLR camera, alright? All the pictures that I'm taking is from my smartphone itself. So the second reason is a light stand is more affordable than a typical smartphone's tripod, alright? And let me tell you one thing, a typical smartphone's tripod costs about 1,500 to 2,000 in Indian price, alright? But whereas a light stand starts from 800, well, that's way cheaper. You might be thinking that a light stand costs cheaper than a smartphone's tripod, so that means the quality of it is cheap too. Well, that's not the case over here. A light stand weighs more than a tripod does, alright? And that means it's sturdy enough and it can hold your smartphone very perfectly without taking risks. As you can see in this video, the light stand is much sturdy and it is taller, alright? And it can hold your smartphone with a tripod clamp too. Whenever you shoot outfit pictures, just make sure that you keep your smartphones upside down. The reason behind it is it will make sure that your full outfit covers right from the top to bottom in one picture. It's not necessary that you only have to use this method while using a tripod. Well, if you're giving a smartphone to someone else to click your picture, that person should follow the same too. So always use this method while shooting your outfit pictures, and I'm sure that you will definitely get some pretty good images and you will thank me later. To shoot portraits, make sure that you keep your smartphones normally, like how usually you click your pictures, without rotating it to upside down. Now to take pictures, make sure that you have your timer on for about 10 seconds so that you can have the time to pose. But sometimes you might feel it's uncomfortable that you have to turn on the timer and then get back to the place and give a pose, and that time is not sufficient for you to give a pose and get back to the position. So for that, what you can do is you can buy a remote shutter for your smartphones. It's a Bluetooth remote shutter. You can have a look at this. This is a Bluetooth remote shutter where you have to click the button whenever you want to click the picture, and that will make sure that you do not have to move from the position at all. If you guys want a separate video on how to pose for your pictures, then let me know in the comment section below. I will definitely make a detailed video for you guys. But if you are in a hurry, then make sure that you check out my Instagram reel. I have given you 3 simple poses for you guys if you don't have any poses in your mind. Now let's talk about portrait shots. These days, everyone has a good smartphone which is equipped with a portrait mode in their camera application. Now, if you're gonna use that portrait mode in your smartphone, then make sure that you stand about 1 meter away from your smartphone, not more than that and not less than that. You know why? I'll tell you now. This is because of your smartphone's camera lens, which is limited to a certain distance. Otherwise, if you exceed that distance, then you won't get that bokeh or blur effect in your background, which means there's no point of shooting pictures in your portrait mode. It will come out to be a normal picture only. If you are using portrait mode in the outdoors, then make sure that you do not rotate your phones upside down, alright? This is because you don't want your complete body. You just need up till your chest or your tummy. Now let's take this one step further, shall we? If you really have a good smartphone and it has a good portrait mode, then you can definitely get some amazing pictures as close to a DSLR camera. And what I'm talking about is a studio pictures, something like this. To achieve this look, you need a softbox or something which can diffuse your light. A basic softbox does a pretty good job for beginners. I recently bought a new softbox and the pictures were taken with the help of these softbox. And this is pretty cheap, alright? I leave a link in the description below if I get a link to this softbox. All you have to do is set up a softbox on a light stand and attach a LED bulb on it. Well, it depends that how many LED bulb you want to use depending upon your softbox size. Mine is 80 centimeters and I'm gonna use only one bulb. You have to repeat the same process for taking portrait shots. A pro tip here is to keep the light at your 2 o'clock or 10 o'clock. This is what many famous photographers use for their lighting setup. They keep the softbox on 2 or 10 o'clock. Now select portrait mode and reduce the exposure and lock it. Remember, you can always increase the exposure in your editing softwares, but if you decrease it in the editing softwares, then it's gonna lose a lot of pixels and plus you're gonna get a grainy image. Hey, if you want a separate video on how to edit pictures like this, then make sure that you leave a comment down below. I'll definitely make a separate video for you guys. A bonus tip here is to try different camera angles rather than pointing it right in front of your face. If you want some inspiration related to men's fashion and photography, then you can definitely follow me on Instagram, that is @justritesh_21. Thank you so much for watching this video. Leave a like to this video, subscribe to my channel and turn on post notification, because whenever I post a new video, you will get notified. See you soon in the next video. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.